In today's video, we will discuss about the hyoid bone. First of all, it is a U-shaped bone. It develops from second and third brachial arches. कुछ पार्ट हायोइड बोन का सेकेंड ब्रेकियल आर्च से डेवलप होता है, कुछ थर्ड से होता है. इट इज़ सिचुएटेड इन द एंटीरियर मिड लाइन ऑफ द नेक बिटवीन द चिन एंड द थायरॉइड कार्टिलेज. इन दिस डायग्राम हियर वी हैव द चिन, हियर वी हैव द थायरॉइड कार्टिलेज. सो इसके मिडिल में ही हमारा हायोइड बोन प्रेजेंट होता है इन द मिड लाइन ऑफ द नेक. एट रेस्ट इट लाइज एट द लेवल ऑफ थर्ड सर्वाइकल वर्टीब्रा. इट इज़ केप्ट सस्पेंडेड इन द पोजिशन बाय द मसल्स एंड द लिगामेंट्स. Since hyoid bone is the only bone in the body which doesn't articulate with any bone, so isse stabilize karne ke liye we will have muscles and ligaments. Now, hyoid bone provides attachment to muscles of floor of mouth, the tongue above, larynx below, and epiglottis and pharynx behind. So, hyoid bone apne piche ki taraf epiglottis and pharynx ko attachment dega, larynx ko apne below, tongue ko apne upar, and muscles of floor of mouth ko bhi upar. This is a diagram of hyoid bone. It has three parts: the body, the lesser horns or lesser cornua, and greater horns or greater cornua. Now we divide the hyoid bone into two parts: the central part and two pairs of cornua. In the central part we have body, in the two pairs of cornua we have lesser and greater cornua. Here in the red color we have the body, green color shows the greater horn, and the yellow color shows the lesser horn. Now, body has two surfaces and two borders. Borders kaun se ho jayenge? The upper border and the lower border. Surfaces kaun se? The anterior surface and the posterior surface. Jo anterior surface hai, it is convex, it is directed forwards and upwards, it is divided by a median ridge into two lateral halves. While the posterior surface, it is concave and it is directed just opposite to the anterior border, that is backwards and downwards. In this diagram we can see we have the anterior surface, it is divided into two lateral halves by the median ridge, it is convex in shape, it is directed upwards and forwards, whereas the posterior surface, it is directed backwards and downwards and it is concave in shape. Now each lateral end of the body is continuous posteriorly with a greater horn or the greater cornua. So in this diagram we can see we have the greater cornua, the body is continuous with the greater cornua, but till middle life the connection is fibrous, afterwards it becomes bony. In this diagram also we can see how the body is connected to the greater cornua. The lesser cornua projects as a conical projection from the body. Now after the body, let's talk about the greater cornua. It is flattened from above downwards. Each cornua tapers posteriorly but ends in a tubercle. The greater cornua has also two surfaces and two borders. The two borders are medial and lateral border, but the surfaces are upper and lower surface. After the greater cornua, let's talk about the lesser cornua. From the junction of the body and greater cornua, conical pieces of bone project upwards. These conical pieces are the lesser cornua. The lesser cornua are connected to the body by fibrous tissue, while the greater cornua was connected to the body till middle life by fibrous connections and afterwards bony connections. Occasionally they are connected to greater cornua also by synovial joints. Abhi hum hyoid bone ki sari attachments padhne wale hain. First anterior surface of body se kya kya attachments hone wale hain. So it gives origin to hyoglossus which extends up to greater cornua and insertion to geniohyoid and mylohyoid. In this diagram we can see from the anterior surface of the body of hyoid bone, the geniohyoid and the mylohyoid both insert there. In this diagram we can see we have hyoglossus anterior surface of hyoid bone se and it continues till the greater cornua. And again here we have hyoglossus, it takes origin from the anterior surface of hyoid bone and it continues up to the greater cornua. Now let's talk about the attachments in the upper border of the body. So here we have insertion to lower fibers of geniogloci and the thyrohyoid membrane. In this diagram we can see we have the thyrohyoid membrane which is inserted into the upper border of the body. Here we have the geniogloss muscle which is inserted into the upper border of the body. After the anterior and upper border of the body, we have the lower border of the body. It gives attachment to pretracheal fascia, and in front of the fascia, medially sternohyoid is inserted, and laterally the superior belly of omohyoid takes origin. In this diagram, we can see we have the pretracheal fascia, which is inserted into the lower border of the hyoid bone. In this diagram, we can see laterally we have the omohyoid, medially we have the sternohyoid, and below the omohyoid, the attachment of thyrohyoid muscle occurs. It extends back to the lower border of the greater cornua. इस डायग्राम में हम देख सकते हैं ये थायरोहायोइड मसल है, ये इंसर्ट होती है ग्रेटर कॉर्नुआ के लोअर बॉर्डर पे, एंड इट इज इंसर्टेड बिहाइंड द सुपीरियर बेली ऑफ द ओमोहायोइड. नाउ लेट्स कम टू द मीडियल बॉर्डर ऑफ द ग्रेटर कॉर्नुआ. इसमें थ्री थिंग्स अटैच होती हैं. वी हैव द थायरोहायोइड मेम्ब्रेन, वी हैव द स्टाइलोहायोइड मसल, एंड डायगैस्ट्रिक पुली. इन दिस डायग्राम वी हैव द थायरोहायोइड मेम्ब्रेन विच इज इंसर्टेड इन टू द मीडियल बॉर्डर ऑफ द ग्रेटर कॉर्नुआ. This is the stylohyoid muscle, which is inserted into the medial border of the greater cornua. In yellow color, we have the digastric pulley, which is inserted into the medial border of the greater cornua. After medial, we have the lateral border of the greater cornua, which gives insertion to the thyrohyoid muscle anteriorly, an investing layer of deep fascia. In this diagram, we can see we have the thyrohyoid muscle, which is inserted behind the superior belly of the omohyoid, in the lateral border of the greater cornua. And here I have highlighted the investing layer of the deep fascia, which is also inserted into the lateral border. After the greater cornua, let's talk about the lesser cornua. It gives attachment to stylohyoid ligament at the tip, origin to the middle constrictor muscle from its posterolateral aspect, extending onto the greater cornua. In this diagram, we have the middle constrictor muscle, which takes origin from the lesser cornua, extending up to the lateral border of the greater cornua. And here we have the stylohyoid ligament, which takes origin from the tip of the lesser cornua. Now our last topic is the development of the hyoid bone. The body is divided into two parts, the upper part and the lower part. The upper part, along with the lesser cornua, takes origin from the second brachial arch, and the lower part, along with the greater cornua, takes origin from the third brachial arch. Thank you.